Hello students, welcome to the class on editorial decode, and in this class I will be decoding The Devil is in the Fine Print, written by Yogendra Yadav. Now from examination point of view, this will help you in general studies mains examination paper 2, plus very important for public administration and political science optional students. Now this editorial is about the recent reforms that has been pronounced in this year's budget, reforms with respect to the funding for the political parties, reforms how the donations are done to the political parties. Now why this is important and what is the nitty-gritty of these reforms, so we will be discussing all these things in this specific class. First of all, we need to understand why election reforms are important, why the funding to the political parties should be made very transparent, and what has been the issue till date. Now we have election commission, we also have law commission. Now these bodies, they have been focusing on this electoral reforms since long. They have been talking about the need of why the election reforms should be done. Now election reforms should be done because corruption in the elections, corruptions in the domain of how the funding is done to the political parties, is one of the biggest reason of why corruption has sustained for so long in India. So there is a kind of opaqueness how the funding is done to the political parties. Now this opaqueness creates the condition for crony capitalism. This creates the conditions for biasness, how the polity is conducted in India. This creates the problem of inclination or disinclination in the polity, in the end, in the conduct of the polity. So if you want to have a fair conduct in the polity, it is important that there should be transparency in the political funding, how the political funding is done, how the donation to the political parties is done. So this year's budget, it has come out with certain reforms. The first reform is, now this editorial is more about looking, delving deep into whether the reform that has been introduced, are they really the reforms? Should the changes that has been introduced, should they be really given the name of a reform? Because at the phase they look that the reforms has been done. But when we will delve deep into these reforms, you will find that the situation has been made more worse than it was existing in the past. First of all, we must know about the past situation. What is the past situation about the funding or the donation to the political parties? Now the past situation, you have one cardinal thing, that any funding below 20,000 done to a political party, it is not required to be mentioned in the income tax return of a political party. So this is one of the main thing, that if a particular party, political party, is receiving donation below 20,000, then that particular party is not required to put this thing in its income tax return. It is not required to tell to the people, tell to the income tax authorities. It is not required to make it public if the donation is less than 20,000 from a particular source. So this is the thing, this is the provision that is criticized mostly by the Election Commission of India. And this is the thing that Election Commission really wanted to do away with this. But this has not been done away with. So the present past situation is existing still as it was existing in the past. No change has been done to this. Now what changes has been done? Change number one. Very important to understand. Change number one that has been done is about that the maximum donation that you can make to a party in the cash form, in the cash form, it should be just rupees 2000. And if you want to give more money than 2000 to a political party, then you can give as much money as you want. There is no upper limit. And but in the form of cash, the party will be receiving just 2000 rupees, not more than that. So this is one change that has been done. Earlier this limit was 20,000 rupees, and beyond 20,000, if you want to give to a particular party, that is given in the form of check or in the form of draft or digital transfer, or the digital transaction has to be carried out. But this has been reduced to rupees 2000. And the second change that has been done, that the political parties are entitled to receive funds by way of check or by way of digital transaction. Ye pehle bhi tha, ab bhi hai. So this is the second change that has been done. Now change number three. It relates to electoral bonds. Electoral bonds. Now suppose somebody want to transfer 19,000 rupees to a particular party, then that particular party will not be required to mention from where it had received this 19,000 rupees. Now if this 19,000 will be transferred by way of check or it will be transferred by way of digital transaction, still the party will not be liable to tell the people the source of its funding. So anonymity of the donor will be maintained if the amount to a particular party will be given by way of check or by way of digital transaction. So this anonymity thing that the Election Commission wanted to be removed is still existent. So I am insisting on this thing again and again. No big change, no big reform has been introduced by this year's budget with respect to the donation and the political funding of the political parties. Because if you want a change, if you really want a reform, the political parties must mention in its accounts, in its income tax return, that from where it has received this 20,000 rupees of donation or less than 20,000 rupees of donation. There should be no anonymity with respect to this, because we want a transparency. So transparency is that you have just changed the mode of how the funding will be given to a political party, but you have not changed this element of anonymity. Aapne sirf way of paisa kaise dena hai political party ko wo change kiya hai. Aur 2000 rupaye tak aap cash mein de sakte ho, cash se kam mein 2000 rupaye tak de sakte ho. Agar aapne upar dena hai to aap 20,000 rupaye tak de sakte ho, 20,000 se upar bhi aap de sakte ho. That I will be telling you now how to fund a political party using electoral bonds. Now this year's government, it has come out with a proposal in its budget that the electoral bond should be used to fund political parties. Now first of all, let us understand what is meant by electoral bonds. Now according to government, जो लिटरल बॉन्ड होता है उसका डेफिनेशन बिल्कुल अलग होता है, बट गवर्नमेंट हैज कम आउट विद दिस पर्टिकुलर डिवाइस ऑफ इलेक्टोरल बॉन्ड इन द कंटेक्स्ट ऑफ हाउ द फंडिंग शुड बी डन टू अ पॉलिटिकल पार्टी. सो आई विल बी डिस्कसिंग दिस फ्रॉम दैट पर्सपेक्टिव. सो इलेक्टोरल बॉन्ड विल बी इशूड बाय अ बैंक टू अ पर्टिकुलर डोनर हु वॉन्ट्स टू डोनेट सम फंड्स टू अ political party. Suppose I want to donate 10 crore rupees to BJP. So I will go to bank, I will provide them with the cash and they will provide me with bond. And what will be written on that bond? It will be written rupees 10 crore rupees for BJP. But it will not be mentioned who I am. It will not be mentioned who has created this bond. So in the form of electoral bond, the money that will be given to the bank, that will be given by me, the bond will be issued by the bank, the bond will be given to the BJP can come to the bank and redeem it. BJP wo bond wapas deke bank se 10 crore rupaya nikal sakti hai. But ye BJP ko nahi pata lagega ki wo paisa unko kisne diya hai. So what is the purpose, what is the intent behind this electoral bonds? The intent behind this electoral bond is that directly political party ko funding nahi deni hai. Ki aap unko influence kar sako. So this is the intent. But agar maine kisi political party ko 10 crore rupay dene, maine BJP ko bata diya ki maine aapko 10 crore rupay de raha hoon. And 10 crore rupay main aapko electoral bond kal la dunga. So this is an indirect way of fooling the people that the government has come out with electoral reforms, because at the face this is not a reform. Chahe to aap paisa directly hand over kar dijiye political party ko, chahe aap electoral bond kar dijiye. Electoral bond इसलिए बोला है कि आपकी एनोनिमिटी बनी रहेगी, पॉलिटिकल पार्टी इन्फ्लुएंस नहीं होगी. बट वो आदमी जिसने 15 50 100 करोड़ रुपए पॉलिटिकल फंडिंग देनी है, वो पहले पॉलिटिकल पार्टी को बताने जाएगा, एक्स प्रेसिडेंट को बताने जाएगा. अगर बीजेपी का देना है अमित शाह को बताने जाएगा, अगर कांग्रेस को देना है सोनिया गांधी को बताने जाएगा, अगर समाजवादी पार्टी को देना है तो उधर बताने जाएगा. सो जो एनोनिमिटी का एलिमेंट है कि किसने फंडिंग की है, एक तो उसको इंटैक्ट कर दिया गया है, क्योंकि इलेक्टोरल बॉन्ड से पता ही नहीं लगेगा आम आदमी को कि कहां से फंड आ रहे हैं. सो बेसिकली द एलिमेंट ऑफ अनोनिमिटी इज स्टिल एग्जिस्टेंट. इंट्रोड्यूस क्या, दो चीजें नई इंट्रोड्यूस क्या की है, दैट थ्रू बैंक यू कैन क्रिएट दिस इलेक्टोरल बॉन्ड and through this you can fund the political party. This is one new thing that has been introduced. And the second thing is that in the form of cash you can only donate rupees 2000, not more than that. And the third thing, that below 20,000 the political party will not be liable to mention ki kisne paise diye. 20,000 se niche batane ki zarurat nahi hai political party ko abhi bhi ki kisne unko ye paisa diya hai. यहां पे भी अनोनिमिटी मेंटेन की गई है. रियलिटी में व्हाट शुड बी द इलेक्टोरल रिफॉर्म्स, इट शुड बी वेरी ट्रांसपेरेंट फ्रॉम वेयर अ पॉलिटिकल पार्टी इज एक्चुअली रिसीविंग फंड्स. इलेक्टोरल बॉन्ड शुड नॉट बी अनोनिमस. इलेक्टोरल रिफॉर्म, इलेक्टोरल बॉन्ड मस्ट ऑल्सो मैंशन द नेम ऑफ द डोनर एंड द पोलिटिकल पार्टीज मस्ट ऑल्सो टेक ऑल द मनी by way of digital transaction, and it all must also mention from where it has received this donation. So what actually the political parties do, agar unko 50 crore rupaya aata hai anonymous way se, black money aati hai, to we kya karte hain, they do it, they divide it in the form of 20,000 20,000 and 20,000. So this is what is done by the accountant. And Jugendra Yadav has also mentioned that this exercise will increase the work of only the accountants. They will be paid more amount of money for the services that they will be offering to the political parties. But in essence it will not alter how the corruption takes place and how the political parties are influenced. So this was all for the editorial decode. You can subscribe to this channel. Name of the channel is BrainyIAS. You can contact me at 84594-0000 in case you're interested in buying the video classes on entire civil services preparation. And in order to avail the information of the classes, please visit BrainyIAS.com. So this was all for the day. Bye-bye. Take care. Have a nice day.